Did you capitalize all of your menu navigation and now you changed your mind and you want them to all be uppercase? Not a problem. Today, I'm going to show you with a little bit of CSS how you can transform your text to either all capital or lowercase or uppercase. And I'm going to show you also how to do it on your desktop, mobile, or both. So let's jump into today's video and let's get started. All right, so now we are in our dashboard and I'm actually going to use the Dawn version 14. It was just released yesterday. Go check it out if you haven't updated your Dawn theme in a while. Lots of good upgrades have been happening. So let's go ahead and customize this. And then we're gonna head over to our header. So our header section is right over here. And then we're gonna come all the way down to our custom CSS section right here. And what I like to do is work with the custom CSS section here because you can see the sections that you make on your website right away. So the first code that I'm going to show you here is how to add uppercase to all of your menus, whether it's desktop or mobile. So you'll see, take a look at here, you'll see right away as soon as I paste this code that that menu is going to change. And there we have it. All right, so I'm going to go ahead and save that. And now you'll see that all of my menus are all uppercase. So whether it's on the desktop or it's on mobile, you'll see that everything is uppercase. Okay. Now let's head over to the front end of our website. Let's just take a quick look here. And there we have it. Okay. Now, if you only want the uppercase in the desktop and not the mobile, which is what probably I would do, then all you have to do is just remove this comma here and all of this section right there. Okay, so just leave the dot header inline menu. Let's go ahead and save that. And then that will have, so just that your desktop is the uppercase and then your mobile stays exactly what it was before, which is the capital. Okay, and you'll see here. So now you have flexibility with this one. The other CSS code that you could use with text transformation, you can use uppercase, you can use capitalize, and you can also use lowercase. Now, the next code that I'm going to show you is only for the top level menu. So if we head over to our top level menu, so only this here, and when we go to the drop down, so your sub menu, it'll all stay capitalized, okay? So that's how you'll have it here. So we'll go ahead and save that. So that is the code. So then you'll see that the top level menus are uppercase. And then when you click on your submenus, it will stay capitalized or lowercase, however you want to show that. Okay. So you'll see here the inline menu will stay uppercase and the submenu will be capitalized. Okay. So you can customize this however you'd like. Now I'm going to show you, in case you're not using Dawn or any of the free themes, you're using a premium theme, you can still use CSS code. I'm going to show you how to find it within your theme. You come to the front end of your website and then you're going to right click and then click on inspect. Okay. And then this is going to look a little bit scary, but don't worry. Click right here where it says select an element. Make sure that it's highlighted there. And then you grab your mouse and hover over the section that we want to inspect. Okay. So we're going to hover over this area here, right? And then you're just going to click on that section here. We're going to come over here. And what we're going to do, you see how it says the header inline menu, right? Which matches the code that we have here, header inline menu. Okay. So that's what we're targeting right there. So yours might say something different. And the next one would be here, the list menu. Okay, so this is how you can tailor it to your specific theme. So what you'll do is that you can just double click on that. You just copy that and then bring it over to your custom CSS and just add a dot in front of it. So let me show you. I can click right here, press the period, and then paste the inline. Okay, so that's how you can find what it is for your specific theme. Okay, I hope that helps. Now, once you have your CSS the way that you want it, now what we could do is that you can leave it just like this. You can leave it right here. It's not going to harm your theme in any way. But if you'd like to add this code to the back end of your website, I'm going to show you how to do that. And the reason you might want to do that is because the custom CSS section here is limited. I believe it's 500 characters or so. So, I mean, like I said, you can leave it here, but if you want it, to enter it on the back end of your website so that you can free this up for any possible further customizations that you want to make. How you would do that, let's go ahead and just delete that right there. What you'll do is that you'll cut this from here. So you'll cut that from here. Let's go ahead and save that. So you see everything goes back to what it was. We're going to go to the edit code. All right. And then once this loads up, you're going to go into your assets folder here. We're going to go to the base CSS. We're going to go all the way to the very bottom and give yourself some space here. And then you'll enter that code right there. Okay. What I would suggest for you to do is to write a note for yourself here so that in case when you come back later on, you might not remember what this code is. So you can enter something here for maybe the header navigation code or, you know, whatever it is that is going to remind you of what this code is. Okay. So then what you'll do here is you'll just click save. Right. And then we'll go back to the front end of our site and let's go ahead and refresh. And then you'll see the code is exactly the same how we just applied it. All right, we'll go here. Let's go ahead and refresh that. And here it is. Okay, so it'll remove the code from here. So it'll free up the space here and it'll just be on your back end. Okay, so you could either way you do it, you won't be wrong. You can do it either way. The reason I like to actually use the custom CSS and leave it here is that when you update your theme, this code stays with your theme, but anything you add in the back end of your code doesn't, right? It gives you a fresh theme every single time. So then you have to try to remember all the customizations you've made. You have to try to remember where they are and then copy them into your new theme. So I like to have it here, but that's just for me. All right. So I hope that you enjoyed this video. Stay tuned to next week. I'm going to show you how to add color and maybe increase the font size to the navigation should you need to. Or until then, go ahead and check out my playlist here where I show you how to customize other text areas within your Shopify store. Until next time, my friend, adios. Check out these. You want them to all be capital? So until next time, my friend, what is this?